Sabrina 70s comic, issue 45. Hilda's actually excited about Ambrose being in love this time, when last time she hated it because all of his girlfriends were mean to her. I guess Hilda likes this girlfriend. And Sabrina's not mentioning what happened with the story with Velma in it at all. Ambrose asks for a 12th cup of tea from Matilda. I can't buy that anyone would drink more than 2 cups of tea in a row. That's just too much to drink. And they don't need to draw hearts around them after the first panel, when their expressions and body language are obvious enough. Matilda says they'll see each other tonight, and Ambrose is so happy they want to celebrate by buying a cake for Hilda and Sabrina. I'm guessing he'll lose his girlfriend at the end of this one story, even though that's a significant idea and she's a good character. Hilda and Sabrina suck at hiding their magic. Sabrina assumes that the ugly woman giving Ambrose the cake is Ambrose's girlfriend, just because he's still happy from his actual girlfriend. That's dumb. No one would assume that was his girlfriend. Why doesn't she simply approach Ambrose and ask a single question? That would immediately clear things up. Then Sabrina gets offended at the old lady calling Ambrose silly just for being positive, and instead of using magic to mistreat her in any other way like I'd expected, she forces her to be infatuated with Ambrose. She crosses a line that even Hilda doesn't cross. Well, she'd have a boyfriend already. So, this is gonna be predictable. Because of bullshit, Ambrose's girlfriend dumps him after he's forcibly kissed by a woman he's clearly not into. Reverse the genders and see how that'll go over. Why does she have to answer the phone for him and yell that she's interrupting a love scene? And I guess she'll never give Ambrose another chance. I have a question. Why doesn't Ambrose just use magic to undo all of this immediately? He'd make her forget this ever happened. Just like the witches always do to keep magic a secret. Also, at this point, I want to put it past Sabrina to cast a love spell on Ambrose too. That story sucked. It's like the writer immediately got jealous of Ambrose and wanted to immediately crush his happiness and thought it'd be hilarious. I'm not mad at Sabrina for using love spells, because she's established to be naive. So she just takes love spells at face value and wants to make people happy, and is too stupid to think about it any further. I think she'd need to be the victim herself to actually get it. Maybe. But why did she have to be there and follow him and not ask any questions? The story wouldn't make me so angry if it weren't for the fact that I know it's such an episodic comic that I know that if she breaks up with Ambrose, it's permanent. When that doesn't make any sense. He can reverse time. It's hard to think of a way for them to break up that wouldn't be aggravating. Like Hilda breaking them up. Maybe Matilda could have gotten sick and grossed them out too much. But that make him look like a fickle jerk when he might never get anyone better than her. Archie Sonic handled shipping better than this. At least it had the courage to have a relationship last for more than one story. In the next story, once again there's a story that starts out with Harvey feeling inferior as he's taking a walk with Sabrina. He actually says that he might not even be here tomorrow. Out of nowhere, Sabrina decides that maybe Della the head witch could help her, even though she's the head witch and is always encouraging her to be evil and doesn't like mortals at all. It's not like they're best friends. What could Della do that she couldn't? Sabrina never thinks she needs Della's help. She wants to give Harvey confidence. Totally missing the fact that every single time he was given any reason to feel good about himself, he immediately became overconfident and screwed up. Then she says, in another leap, that she should make him confident by turning him into a warlock. Yeah, if you're gonna have him screw up, just go all the way. At least that'll be entertaining. Del's furious right away. Probably because she hates mortals so much that she continued to hate one even after he was turned into a member of her own kind. Which isn't unrealistic, even if it's rational. She says hypocritically that mortals can't handle magic. Well, judging by the way Sabrina and Hilda abuse magic, nobody can handle magic. And Della makes sure of that by forcing witches to use magic for evil all the time to meet a quota, and punishing witches that don't. So why is she even talking about this? If she means that any mortal who got magic would freak out and think he's gone crazy, that could be made to go away by a single spell, so what's the problem? I expected her to just outright admit that she'd hate a mortal no matter what. Sabrina says that she only wants him to be a witch until he stops feeling so inferior. So, he'd be a witch for an hour, not even a day. It sure is nice of Della to agree to this ridiculous demand. She says that it's her responsibility. Now you're about being responsible? Won't she remember that the masquerade is maintained no matter what and want her to be responsible? Sabrina's nice enough to thank her as I wish that there are just two separate characters, Della and another character for the evil Della. These two don't go together. Sabrina thinks with an impressed smile that once Harvey gets a taste of power, he'll be a new man. Isn't it really obvious that this will backfire? Doesn't she know him at all? I'm really excited and hyped to see him use magic for once. But I'm too distracted by how stupid Sabrina's being. And really, any witch can just give a mortal power. She can just create new magic out of nothing. Wouldn't this be what she'd need Della's help for? Instead, she just got her permission. It makes sense if she put the magic of a bunch of magic-infused things into Harvey. Like the magic of Hilda's potion ingredients. Maybe that's where her magic got the new magic from. Harvey feels a sort of jolt because the magic was nice enough to give him a sign that it came into him so that he'd use it. He wishes that a bully named Benson, who's apparently infamous enough to earn a nickname Bully Benson, would be given a boot in the rear. Harvey sees his wish come true, and somehow, when he asks who kicked him, he doesn't turn around and beat up Harvey like I immediately expected. We don't get to see Harvey beat him up with his wishing. And he's not that thin that the tree would hide him. The tree should have been drawn to be bigger. Harvey wishes that some other creep would get creamed. I guess he knows him as a bully too, because all I see is an ugly guy with good taste in jackets. Too bad he's spiteful instead of wanting to turn them good. Considering how often magic is literal-minded, it's lucky for Harvey that his magic actually knew what he meant and didn't just cover him in cream. Or cover him in cream and beat him up. He gets whacked by an invisible force and falls over. And Harvey immediately smirks evilly at getting a psychic power and thinks it's fun to be dishing out for a change. He didn't have to be drawn with a smirk. I have to assume that Seymour and Marty are evil too. I wish I was told that. Because it'd be out of character for a nice guy like Harvey otherwise. He makes it obvious that he's to blame by asking for a couple of melons across the domes, and they get hit in the head with melons. Sabrina hypocritically thinks that she's created a monster, without doing the self-reflection to realize that she's not above this at all. She's protected him from tough guys who tried to beat him up. I wish she asked Harvey why he did this, like would be in character. Maybe she was just too scared that he'd use magic against her, like turn her into a frog that would be unable to use magic. He does cheat on her, so it's not like he can really be trusted. And it's not like it wasn't foreshadowed that he'd do anything shady. The plot could have progressed more naturally from here if Sabrina was told that all of those guys were bullies. The kind of people she would have picked on anyways. Like at the beach. People don't even have to be outright bullies to everyone for Sabrina to use her magic against them. All it takes is for someone to be mean to her, or someone she loves. Or a woman could flirt with her boyfriend. She's being a hypocrite by assuming that because Harvey does it, he's a monster and it's wrong. But whenever she does the same thing, it's okay. Realistically, she wouldn't take away his powers here. She would question him on it. The story ends with a tough guy hitting Harvey as Della and Sabrina are hypocrites. It's not unrealistic for a character to be a hypocrite. Plenty of people are. But if Sabrina wasn't, it would have been more interesting. She's usually portrayed as a goody-two-shoes. The comic could have been self-aware of the fact that Sabrina isn't as nice as she thinks she is. Logically, she would be told why Harvey was doing this and side with him. Why wasn't this the whole issue? Well, the whole issue is stretching it, but this is a significant story idea. There's so much more that he could have done with magic, though it already got repetitive. Imagine a whole episode of a show about this. It could have also taken advantage of actual character traits of his, like his appetite, or his desire to be great at sports, or his love of fishing. He could ask for giant fish. Sabrina could be the moral compass to him when it came to that. And then she'd be justified in doing this. She wouldn't want him to get really fat eating giant food he summoned. Or become a sports star because of his magic. Wouldn't it make sense if we saw him use his magic against Hilda, and that provoked her? Instead, he just uses it against enemies of his that came out of nowhere purely for this one story. The minute he got magic, he reminded me of Scourge. He was probably messing with the school bullies too, because he didn't have Robotnik to fight. Sabrina should have had a thought in a thought bubble that made it clear that she was just too scared to ask Harvey what he had against those guys. Still, if she loves Harvey, she'd have faith in him that he had a good reason. She just lost all communication skills and cast magic without asking a question, again. If the story wanted to accurately show us that Harvey was jumping off a slippery slope, then it needed to clearly establish that he was targeting the other three men for unjustified reasons. He didn't even get a chance to jump off the slippery slope first. It's not like he used his magic to bully nerds. He didn't use it to get out of paying for stuff, or use a love spell on a woman. He could have used one on Sabrina after she calls him out, so she'd be just infatuated with him all the time. And then Dale would have to step in and return things to normal. That would be a better ending, because she'd be a Chekhov's gun woman. And then we'd see him do something that everyone would see as wrong, instead of using his magic to give bad guys a taste of their own medicine. Which is something a lot of people would relate to wanting, not just bad people. It was Harvey's anger getting the better of him that he didn't even consider making them nice instead of just hurting them. But even someone as eager to help as Sabrina never did that to anyone, so who is she to judge? Instead she just thinks he's a monster for doing the same things she's done to anyone who upsets her. Because she didn't know the context, which isn't as satisfying as her telling him off for doing something she would never do. Harvey's been shown to be too girl crazy before. Once he used magic for that, then it'd be immediately understandable that he'd lose his powers because Sabrina would get jealous again. I guess the writing was lazy with how it took it, being too repetitive and predictable. In the next story, Sabrina tells Hilda that she's out of style. Once again, Hilda's told that her witch costume is tacky. It's out of character at this point for her to agree with them and be sad instead of getting mad when she's always been proud of her outfit because she's proud of being a witch. It'd be less forced if it was established that Hilda was sad about something else and was depressed enough to agree with them. Hilda's been dressed like a witch their whole lives, and she's still surprised at these insults. This is not the first time they've had this conversation. Sabrina looks up the latest fashion magazine. And Hilda actually smiles at seeing her new clothes despite the yellow shirt that draws too much attention to it and the shade of yellow clashing with the purple skirt. Her blue hat doesn't go well with it either. Sabrina and Ambrose don't like her hair and shoes, despite loving Hilda, so they change those too. If Hilda was able to appreciate these changes, she would have done this to herself years ago to fit in. But she's never cared about fitting in much. For once they happen to catch her in a period of insecurity. This would make sense for Zelda. She gets given a new look that, according to Sabrina, is what the modern day witch is wearing. Hilda thinks that even her old cauldron is passé. I'm pretty sure there's a good reason why witches use large cauldrons. It's so they can make a large amount of potion at once to keep the powers. Wait, she recharges her magic by strapping herself into a battery. Why would she still need potions to keep her powers? Maybe the potions are the fuel for that battery in her house. Anyways, she keeps acting out of character by giving herself a new set of pots and pans. Oh, that's what's gonna justify her going back to normal. She's gonna get mocked by the witches at a witch's coven. How is she not expecting this? I've seen plenty of old-fashioned looking witches in this comic. Aren't they all gonna laugh at her? I guess Hilda's just really confident in herself, because she usually is. She tries to fly away on the vacuum, but it's still plugged in, and she was in such a hurry that she didn't notice. So she falls, and that's what convinces her that the old ways are the best ways. At least that spares her from being mocked by witches, but that doesn't explain why she gave up everything else. She could have still been mocked for her appearance because her face is still ugly, and if she changes that, she wouldn't be her. And she can't make a ton of brew at once with just pots and pans. If she's just that stubborn that she'd go completely back, how did she make any of those changes in the first place? In the next story, the meter reader asks Hilda where her electric meter is. Is this his first time ever visiting the house? Has he just been hired? Maybe he's gone to so many houses that he couldn't possibly remember where hers is. But you'd think her house would be the most memorable one, since she's a witch. Hilda's mad at getting charged for electricity, and he offers to show her how to read it so she'll understand. And she asks him if she'd get charged for the tour. Why did it take so long for this to come up? The meter guy says that the dials measure the number of kilowatt hours of electricity she uses, and he has to write down what the meter registers. She casts a spell to have the dials run backwards so she'll get money instead. And he says that the meter's obviously faulty, and he's confident that he'll have a new one installed in just an hour. Sabrina calls it a destructive, practical joke, and Hilda leaves the house and gets offered the finest piece of meat in the store, which she assumes she can't afford. Do I have the story? The story seems a little familiar to me. Maybe she's valued the antiques in her house that she sells, so she knows what she can afford to splurge on and what antiques have to be kept for tax paying for years to come. If she was literally rich off antiques, she'd be in a mansion, so she's just saving them. She uses magic to make the scale weigh the beef wrong, and this time, Hilda actually gets away with it instead of him assuming the scale is faulty. I guess because he didn't want to say no to the free money in her hand right away. Sabrina calls her out on cheating a man she assumes is nice. Maybe she met him before. Then she can't find the meat because Sabrina brought it home. Since Hilda convinced her it was fun to reverse dials, Sabrina tried on the clock and turned time backwards. So today is now yesterday and she hasn't even gone to the butcher's shop yet. That doesn't make any sense. If time really was reversed, Hilda wouldn't still remember the events of this story. And obviously making a clock run backwards doesn't make time go backwards. It's just forcing the materials of the clock to move counterclockwise against its will. And yeah, the revelation that Sabrina can reverse time really is too overpowered. Makes me wonder why she doesn't use it more often. Most of this issue is made of frustrating stories. The first story completely wastes the idea of Ambrose being in love with a nice woman because the writer got jealous of him and didn't want to change the status quo. So Sabrina somehow assumes that an ugly woman is Ambrose's girlfriend, and because she insults Ambrose rather than Sabrina mistreating the woman and telling Ambrose and getting the full story, she makes the woman madly in love with him, and she answers the phone and completely ruins his relationship. Why doesn't Ambrose just use magic to erase Matilda's memory of this? Witches can do that, and she puts him in such a good mood, making him nicer to his loved ones. So if he did that and continued to date her, we'd notice his good mood. Just because this woman's made infatuated with him, she forces herself on him, instead of simply being heartbroken at getting rejected and leaving like most people would. When if she really loved him, that's what she'd do. Not a very good love spell. It's just about having someone act infatuated no matter what. That being all a witch can do for a love spell is probably why a lot of witches don't bother with them to get a relationship, because that's not what they're looking for. They want a real boyfriend who can also double as a good friend, not just a devoted slave who never stops thinking about them. I can't even say their breakup was inevitable because he could have just erased her memory every time a witch used magic in front of her. The second story completely wastes the concept of Harvey getting magical powers because he does the same three predictable things with it over and over instead of doing what you'd expect of Harvey. He bullies some bullies, making Sabrina hypocritically think he's a monster for doing what she'd do with no self-awareness, and never ask for his side of the story before taking away his powers. He could have summoned a bunch of love-struck women and hamburgers for himself, and gotten revenge on Hilda. That'll make sense for him to do instead of just anyone. Sabrina will be more likely to bond with him over this and do the same thing. Then she'd lecture him and get turned into a frog or brainwashed, and then Del would step in. This should have been completely rewritten to fully take advantage of the concept. Then there's a story where Hilda acts out of character, actually agreeing to modernize herself for no reason. It's not even explained that it's because she got hit in the head, just to go back on it because she forgot to unplug the flying vacuum. She could have just conjured up a vacuum. Sabrina liked flying motorcycles just as much, and they wouldn't have that problem. It's not like Hilda was in an especially insecure mood, and she would have acted proud to cover it up anyways. This story would make sense for Zelda more than Hilda. The final story is about Hilda using magic to mess with an electric meter and scale, and then Sabrina gets rid of the meat she cheated someone out of with magic and says that she turned the clock backwards and rewound time. If she could just do that, she would have undone every mistake that would need that to be undone. Every witch would. So time would never progress. It's too overpowered of an ability. How did Hilda remember what she did if time was set back a day by Sabrina?